Welcome back, everyone. Well, for all of you holding Packers parties tomorrow, we have the perfect easy-to-make recipe. Mason Street Grill's Thomas Hawk is here with a sure Packer party hit. Tuna burgers and little mini
tuna tacos.
Yeah. I'm excited about this one.
Who doesn't
like tuna?
It looks
delicious, the finished product, but how do we start this off?
Real easy, real simple. So you're going to do a couple things and just put it all together. The first thing you got to make is the Colby sauce for the tuna.
Okay.
So you just combine your garlic, your ginger, your pepper.
And slice up the ginger.
Yeah, just peel it, give it a rough chop. Your red pepper flakes, your
crushed
soy sauce.
Crushed red pepper, I'm a fan.
Everybody likes this stuff. A little bit of your sesame, whoops. A little bit of sesame.
And then what was that?
That's your mirin. It's a sweet Japanese wine.
Okay. This is a little Asian inspired.
Yeah, we got a little Asian flavor going on. Take all this, and you're going to just bring it down and cook it for about 10 minutes.
Okay.
Your soy sauce and your sugar. Give it some good sweetness.
Wow, a lot of sugar.
Just a touch. Just a touch. So with the magic there, you get that. That's what that turns out to be.
Okay.
So now once that's done, we're going to take some beautiful tuna.
All right.
We got ahi number one tuna, nice and red, good yellowfin tuna.
Okay.
We got our little tiny wonton taco shells. We got some chopped lettuce. So a little bit of lettuce. Little bit of tuna.
And you made that, though. We made
the
little...
We actually took wonton skins.
Uh-huh. You got to shove it in there.
We just took a ring cutter, and then we just gently fried them.
Okay.
A little bit of avocado. And then a little bit of Colby sauce. And you have a beautiful taco snack.
That is great for a party, just put out there.
And it's real simple, real easy to make. Then the second thing you can do is we make a tuna burger.
Okay.
So we take the rest of the tuna that we chopped up. You just chop it till it looks like ground beef. Soy sauce that we infused with ginger. Some basil. A little bit of chives. And then just a little oil.
I think I'll move this out of the way so the camera can see that.
You just mix it and mix it, and you just want to whip it until the tuna starts to come together. The fat in the tuna is going to release, and it's going to hold itself. And it's going to get real nice, and it'll look just like this.
Okay.
So you got the magic of the patty. And then once the pan gets hot, you just simply put it in the pan.
I'm quite impressed that it turns out like that.
Yeah, the fat in the tuna, once you whip the tuna,
sure,
it's going to hold itself together, so you don't need a binder or anything. And then once the tuna in the pan gets hot, just a quick two sears on both sides.
And this is one of those things you really want to be careful of overdoing it.
Yeah, most people will like tuna very rare.
Uh-huh.
And we do too. So less is always more here. You just want to get a little color on both sides.
So slightly healthy.
Yeah, it's real healthy. I mean, you could always omit the ginger mayonnaise, but everybody likes mayonnaise, so.
Yeah, no, you can't leave that out.
Yeah, but no, it's real good. Tuna's very, very good for you. So you just simply cook the tuna. Little flip, maybe a little bit more than that.
All right, so that's our finished product there in the front. And, of course, we do have these recipes on the food page of our website, wysn.com. You can also go to the Mason Street Grill and check it out for yourself. Thank you so much for joining
us
this morning. Well, if you